Hi everyone, it's Miss Melanie and we are ready to draw, paint, and create. And today we're going to be making a penguin on canvas. So what you need to do is gather your supplies. What you need today is your canvas, your template, you need your acrylic paint. I have a pencil with the eraser on top, a pencil sharpener in case I need it later. I have my little tube of glitter, some paint brushes, the sponge daughter. I have gotten some rinse water. I have gotten a towel. You can use paper towels or some kind of old t-shirt or something like that to dry your brushes on. I've covered my table. I have a blow dryer. This is for drying in between. So with the help of your grown-up, go ahead and get your area set up. Stop the video. When you are ready to go, come back and we'll get started on our artwork. Okay, today the first thing we are going to do is take the template on the canvas. We're going to put it so that it matches in the corner. So when I lay my template down, I want the square edge to line up right here in the corner. I'm going to set that down. I'm gonna hold the template down with my hand and grab my pencil, and I am going to very carefully trace the outline of what's later going to become my penguin. And so what you see right here is the outline. Go ahead and make your outline. Once you have that, you're gonna get the biggest brush that was in your kit, and you are going to grab the blue paint. That blue paint is going to be our sky that I want you to watch carefully. When I put the blue paint on, I am going to start by doing my edges very, very carefully. Go back and forth and fill in that space. So I start by doing an outline. I want to take it slow and I want to fill it in. Now you have some white paint. We need to keep the white paint clean, so you also have a lid. You're going to take some of the white paint and you are going to put it on the lid, just a tiny little bit. I have a plate here. If you have a paper plate you want to use, you can do that as well. I'm gonna stick my brush with the blue in it right inside of the white, and I am going to start blending it as I go. So brush in the blue, little bit of white, do my outline. I'm gonna fill in this whole entire space. Once I'm done with that space, I'm gonna put my brush in the rinse water. When I rinse my brush, I want to make sure I really get all the paint out. So I hold the cup and I go swish, 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 swish. Then I'm going to dry it. I'm going to set that aside and then I'm going to stop the video to blow dry. And so fill in all of your blue, rinse and dry your brush, then you're going to blow dry. Once you've done all those things, turn the video back on and we're going to start on our penguin. All right, now we're ready for the next part, which is to paint our penguin white. Penguins are black and white and they have an orange nose. And so we're gonna start by getting the whole entire thing white. Now the blue is the background for our sky. The white is the first thing we do with our penguin. It's much easier to paint white with black on top than it is to try to cover black with white. So that's why we do the white first. I get my white paint, I dip my brush in, and then I'm gonna very carefully, just like I did with the blue, I'm gonna make sure I go right along those edges. Once I get all of my edges done, then I am going to sweep my brush back and forth across the canvas, and I am going to fill in with white. While I am sweeping back and forth, notice I'm not being really rough with my brush. I'm gently going back and forth to push the paint across the canvas. Refill your brush as you need it. And now you can also see why we didn't want to get our white mixed with the blue. So once I have covered my entire penguin, I just want to make sure that it's very smooth. I don't want any lumps of paint because they make my canvas lumpy when it dries. So make sure you smooth it really good. Once you have all of that white, you can stop the video just long enough to blow dry. Before you do that, make sure you put your white messy paintbrush in the rinse water. When I put it in, again, I swish, 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 making sure that I get all the white out of there. And then I blow dry it. I mean, I'm so sorry. I dry it. Not blow dry. I could blow dry it, but I dry it really good with this towel that I have. And so stop the camera And then you can blow dry, and then we'll be back. Okay, we have our penguin body white and dry, and so now we're gonna pick up a smaller brush. So pick up one of your smaller brushes, and you're gonna need the black paint, and we are going to start by outlining, just like we did before. So I am going to very carefully, notice that I am going slow. Start down here, it doesn't really matter. Now, if your white is still wet, you're gonna end up with gray, so be very careful as you go to make sure that your white is all the way dry. Now, again, this takes time. I have a little lump right there of not dry paint. I could go back to the blow dryer, but I just wiped it off a little bit and then I wiped it on my apron, which is one good reason why you might wear an apron. Okay, so as I work on that outline, I'm gonna continue to go within that, and I'm gonna make it a little bit fatter. I want this to be the outside of him. So I think I've done enough with the little brush. I'm gonna go back to the bigger brush. I have my outline. Now I'm just gonna make his black part a little thicker. So I'm using the big brush to do that. Put the little brush in the water and get the big brush. Now over here, I want it to go off the edge. Like so. So I just take my brush, see how I went off the edge. We're not gonna see his whole body or her whole body. And you can see it a little bit in here on this one that's finished. All right, and you can see how thick I made that one as well. So that's our sample one. I'm gonna go one more time and just smooth this out. So this is a very careful part. Now I did not draw this first. I used my paintbrush to do it, and my paintbrush was used to make the outline. And so if you wanted to draw it first, you could, but on this particular one, since we already have the line from the template, I didn't draw mine. Now, I'm probably not gonna use this brush again. Once you have black in a brush, it can be really hard to get it out and have it not mixed with other things. So I'm gonna drop that down in the water, and I'm gonna leave it in the water. Now I'm gonna locate my sponge. There it is. I'm gonna take the black paint. Notice I didn't stop for the blow dryer. You can keep going on this. This is wet, but that's okay. It can continue drying while we work. I'm gonna take the sponge. I've dipped it in the paint. It's really lumpy. I've got a whole bunch on it. So I'm gonna wipe it on the edge a little bit. I don't want it. So notice how I'm just kind of tapping that. I'm going to make two eyeballs. I'm gonna set it, spin it, lift it. I'm gonna do it over here too. Set it, spin it, lift it. So now I have eyeballs, okay? Once I have done that, it is time to blow dry again. You can reuse this sponge, but not if the paint dries in it. So what I like to do, I like to take the blow dryer, set it down, and I'm gonna turn my canvas this way. I just let this dry with the blow dryer on while I go wash this brush. You can also change out your water since we used the black, but go to a sink, have a grown-up help you, and go ahead and clean the water out of that, not the water, the black out of that sponge so that we can use it again. And while you're doing that, turn the blow dryer on and we'll be back. Okay, we're back. The black is dry, the eyeballs are dry. I took my sponge to the kitchen sink and I rinsed it really good. Once it's been rinsed out, you need to make sure it's really, really dry. We are gonna use this sponge again, and so make sure it's clean, all the black is out. Have a grown-up help you if you need to. All right, setting that down because now I'm ready to draw my beak. I am going to get my pencil and I am going to start right underneath the eyes, and I am gonna draw a flat line. I'm gonna lift it up and show you. So it's just a flat little line. Now you get to decide how big your beak is going to be. It could be a little tiny beak or it can be a great big beak. I'm gonna go for like medium size. It's a triangle, and so I want to draw it like a piece of pizza, pointing down like so. And then once I have drawn that, and make sure I like it, and I've got it nice and ready to go with my paint, I'm gonna go ahead and just drop that, pick up my smaller brush, which mine is still dirty with black, so I'm gonna rinse it, drying it, and I'm gonna grab my orange. I am simply going to get some orange, and I'm gonna fill that in. I go very, very carefully, and just like I did before, I like to do the outline first. So, There we go. Just a little triangular pizza-shaped nose. I'm gonna drop this brush in here. I'm gonna rinse it. Again, I'm swishing it. And I'm drying it so that I can use it later. So, there's my beak. Once I have my little beak done, I'm gonna work on a scarf. If you need to stop the video to do your beak, go ahead and do that. If you don't need to, if you're already done, then we'll just move on. All right, so I'm gonna take my pencil. I'm gonna go underneath my penguin's head. So I'm gonna draw it. It's hard to draw upside down. So I'm gonna draw it like this. Doo-doo-doo. And what I've done is just a line. I did it all the way across. So I'm going to use, I think I'm gonna do a green scarf. I'm gonna get my smaller brush, the one I just cleaned. I'm gonna get green on my brush and I'm gonna come all the way across and I'm just gonna cover that line. Once I have done that, I need to make it thicker. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna draw a line right underneath it like so. Okay, so now I have two lines. Once I have those two lines, I'm gonna get my paint and I'm gonna fill that in. So here I go, filling it in. Okay, there we go. All right, once I have filled that all the way in, then I'm ready to do the knot on the scarf, okay? So, see how that went? Now you can make your scarf thicker. This one is much, I dropped it. This one is much thicker. So when you look at that scarf, you can see that it's much thicker. We will add some details to our scarf, just not yet. So I have my scarf. Do I like it? Is it thick enough? Make that decision. I've decided that I wanna go a little thicker. I kinda like a nice fat scarf because I think if it's chilly outside, which it would be if you're a penguin, since they live in, I think they live in Antarctica. Let's see, they also live in the zoo. That's the only place I have seen them is at the zoo. One of my favorite zoos is the one that is in Chicago. I have also been to the New York Zoo. I've been to the zoo in Dallas. Look at that. I don't know how many zoos you've been to, but I hope you've gotten to see penguins because they're awful cute. Okay, once I have that done, I am now going to make the knot. The knot is just a circle. So when you tie your scarf, you tie it and you have a knot up by your neck. So I'm going to go a circle with my brush all the way around like so. Circle, circle, circle. I'm gonna fill that in. Now, you might notice that there are some black showing through depending on what color you have. Don't worry about that. We're gonna blow dry and then we're gonna add a second coat as we need it. Once I get this in, I'm gonna do the ends of my scarf. So what I do is I draw a line like this and then I draw a line like this. So they're going out in like you're getting ready to start the capital letter A, okay? Once I have that, I am going to draw a line across like I'm making a T, and then I'm gonna bring it back up like so, and I'm gonna fill it in. So go ahead and get your scarf all the way filled in with your knot. Once you have done that, we're gonna stop and blow dry. After you're done blow drying, if you can see any of the black underneath, you will need to do a second coat of paint. Do that before you turn the video back on, okay? I'll see you in just a bit. Okay, we're back and you should have a dry scarf. Now, there's a couple things. If you wanna add some details, first of all, I put a bow on this one's head, but this time I don't want a girl penguin, I want a boy penguin. And so I'm not gonna put a bow on the head. But if you want to do a bow, you can look at mine or you can do it the way you like it. You can draw it first or you can just paint it on. When I do a bow, I start with that circle in the middle, just like I did the circle on the scarf. And then I go out, out, like I did here in like a V or an A, if you were doing the side letters, and then I fill it in. If you do a bow, you'll wanna blow dry it before we decorate. The other thing you can do, which I think would be super cute, is to do earmuffs. So I am going to take this paint and I'm gonna come right here on the side of where the penguin's ears would be. I actually don't know where. I know penguins have ears. I'm guessing they're on the side of their head, just like all the other things in the world. I just don't think you can see them like you can see some kind of other animals. All right, so those are gonna be my headphones. I said headphones, I meant earmuffs. Okay, so I'm gonna go a little bigger, although I do think you can get headphones that are also earmuffs, which would be kind of cool. Let's see, so I've gotten that. Now, what I wanna do, you know how earmuffs have like the thing that holds them on, like a headband? I'm gonna make mine a gray color. So what I'm gonna do is, we still haven't mixed our white up. It should be pretty white, so I'm gonna scoop some of that out. I am scooping it onto my little plate. You can scoop it into the lid. I'm gonna very carefully try not to mess up too much of my black. I'm gonna mix a little bit of black inside the white, and I'm gonna come up with a gray. It's kind of hard to see on this green tray. All right, so I'm gonna now take this, this is upside down to you, and I am going to make the headband that holds the earmuffs. So there we go. Now, what else can I do for details? Well, these are wet, so I do wanna dry them. I'm just not gonna dry them right away. I'm gonna come back to that in just a minute. I'm gonna make rosy cheeks, and so I do rosy cheeks the same way I did my gray. I take a little bit of white, I'm gonna scoop it. This is why it's kind of nice if you have like a tablecloth, because you can mix right on your tablecloth, but again, like an old paper plate would work. I'm dipping a little bit of it in the pink, and I'm gonna swirl it together. So I have mixed white and pink, and I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna make rosy cheeks. I just happen to like rosy cheeks. I think that you get rosy cheeks when you are outside playing in the cold. And I don't know if penguins have cheeks. I guess they do. Kind of fun to find out what penguins have. All right, so now I have some rosy cheeks. Okay, next thing I'm gonna do, this sponge that we cleaned earlier, I'm gonna use it for a couple different things. The first thing I'm gonna use it for, I'm gonna turn it to the spongy end. I'm gonna get some white. When I stick it in, remember that it's really lumpy or thick, and so I wanna tap it on the edge. You can also tap it right on your tablecloth, okay? I'm gonna use it to make polka dots. Doot, doot, doot. I don't know if you notice when I'm dooting, but when I doot, doot, I am doing a little spin. So I set it, spin it, lift it. Set it, spin it, lift it. Set it, spin it, lift it. Okay, I'm ready for some more paint. Gonna make sure it's not too oozy, and I'm gonna go down here, back and forth. Notice that none of mine overlap or touch. I don't wanna overdo it. So I don't want so many polka dots that you can't see my scarf. Now I can do polka dots up here if I want to. I can't do them right now because my earmuffs are still wet. All right, next thing. I'm gonna turn this sponge upside down. I'm going back to my white. I'm dipping it in my white, and I am going to make a little dot. I'm not even pushing down quite all the way. Well, maybe a little bit more, but I'm doing some little dots inside the eye. I am also gonna use this end to make snow. So I'm gonna dip the wooden end in, and I am going to, and I gotta kind of dip and dot, I'm gonna spread out over the painting some snowflakes. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna fill in the whole sky with snowflakes. Once that's done, there's only a couple things that I can do to add, you can do more things, but what I could do to add details. If you wanted to, you can get a Sharpie and you can put eyelashes or eyebrows. You also can use your skinny brush, but if you use your skinny brush for eyelashes, or I'm gonna make eyebrows, make sure you wash it and get it nice and thin, and then the key. Okay, so now I've turned my phone on silent. We are ready to do some little details. You don't have to do anything else. If you're done, you're done. That's fine. You may notice some things on here that are different from yours. So I did stripes here. One of the things that I did not do was add eyelashes. So I'm gonna bring the girl back over. Boys and girls can have eyelashes. Make sure your brush is in skinny mode. I do that. This is really disgusting. I lick mine. Isn't that gross? A lot of artists do that though. So don't lick your brush. I'm really just teasing you. Take your brush, dip it in the water, spin it in your paper towel. That, and then you can use your finger. You wanna get your tip as straight as possible. Then the key is to not get very much paint on your brush. Then I can make eyelashes. I'm gonna make really long ones because I like that. Doo, doo, doo. And there she goes. Nice eyelashes. The other thing that I can do is I can do eyebrows. I don't know if penguins have eyebrows. They probably don't. Lot of animals have eyebrows though, and eyelashes, like llamas have really long eyelashes because they live in the desert and it keeps the dust out of their eyes. I have no idea about penguins. I probably not since they're in the water all the time, but maybe we could look. All right, let's see. Ha, that's a funny eyebrow. I actually like that a lot. I'm gonna do this one too. So now my penguin has funny eyebrows. I think eyebrows give character to your artwork. You can also use the skinny brush if you would like to. I did not do it on my other one, but if you want to, you can come in and you can outline. The problem with outlining is if your brush is too thick, you'll get a big blob of black paint. So I'm only going to outline my nose. And then I'm done with everything but glitter. You may be wondering why we have glitter. The glitter is to add really anywhere you want to do it. So the way that I do glitter, take the lid off, squeeze it. This is just like glitter glue, but you can squeeze it right on your tablecloth. You can use your finger. I just stick my finger in. I'm gonna put it up here. Just rub it over where you want it, and then it'll dry sparkly. So I'm gonna make sparkly earmuffs. Now, on doing the glitter, if your paint is wet at all, the glitter itself won't work very well because you'll be smearing your paint. So make sure everything is really, really dry. And that's the end of our penguin painting. Now, you'll want to put your lids back on your paint, clean your brushes, and save all of these things. Make sure your sponge, now that we used white, gets washed and dried, because we have a craft to do too. Now, the other thing that's in your kit is jewels. I didn't do any jewels on either one of my paintings, but I can do jewels. If you want to add jewels to yours, it's your artwork. And so you can do that. You just use Elmer's glue or whatever you have around the house, okay? I hope you had fun creating your penguin, and I will see you in just a little bit when you're ready to do your craft.